In the energy quadrant, both natural gas and crude oil took a hit, but crude oil went down through $46 on the WTI contract, hitting a 13-month low, rallying back a little bit, but not before finishing down over 3%. We're now down 16% in WTI crude oil in the last 6 days. It's the fifth consecutive session lower. EIA inventories came out yesterday. We saw about a 500,000 barrel build, not enough to really move us in terms of where the inventories are. The inventory are now 3% below the five-year average, which isn't the worst thing if you're looking for a base price in crude oil. Inventories here in the U.S. are below their five-year average. We have spent about 5 years in a crude oil glut, so it's not really saying much, and the demand destruction is real with the coronavirus coming through. But that 2.7 million draw in gasoline also is going to continue to pull a little bit of those inventories out to refill those stockpiles, although that demand destruction based off of, again, the coronavirus, which is spreading through the world quickly, reducing in China, but spreading through the rest of the world quickly, is likely to pull us back up near that five-year average on inventories in the coming months. And lastly, I mentioned COVID-19. OPEC has not agreed to a production cut yet because we don't know how the virus is going to affect demand. That doesn't mean in their April meeting that they're not going to have a production cut, but the Saudi oil minister said that they hadn't agreed to it yet. Now, they're probably looking back to the late 90s, early 2000s, when Japan was trying to manipulate the value of the yen by intervening in that market. And then when they were done intervening, the market would come in and push it back in the original direction anyway. Essentially, the Bank of Japan just wasted money trying to affect the price of the yen. OPEC's probably remembering that lesson, thinking if we cut now, while demand is completely being destroyed by this virus, at least the potential demand is, it may not have the desired effect. And then you're not keeping your powder dry for when the demand spikes back up, which it will if and when this virus gets under control. So we're not sure now, not as sure as we were a month ago, that OPEC was going to cut again, but still the weakness is there. We got below $46 on WTI today, rallied back above it in toward the close.